Good morning to my dear children. Children, today we are going to start a poem, A Grain of Sand by Tabiz Kher. Children, this poem especially relates with the childhood stage of a children's life. Okay, when we are small, we don't know that whether it is useless things or useful things. We think that each and everything is a treasure for us. Each and everything is very valuable for us. This poem is written by Tabiz Kher. And Tabiz Kher has written here beautifully about the stage of a children's life and how the childhood affects a child's life. Especially the most important part in human life, here Tabiz Kher told that childhood is the most important stage of a human life. So let's read out the poem. Look what we found, my children said, unfolding feast into a gift of cork, pin, caption, pebble, shred. The proof that loving eyes can sift, the common silt for hidden gold. Those glimmerings we lose with age, as price is tagged, the story told, and what is lost fills us with rage. I hoard your findings, daughter, son, each little treasure you have named, and pile on my decks one by one. Only like this the world is claimed. It's not enough to find and hold. One needs to learn the art to keep what is found as if it was gold. It's love or faith, it's a leap, without which all is dropped and lost. Unheard, inhospitable grounds, where price is known but not the cause, and nothing can never ever be found. In the first two lines, you see, look what we found, my children said. So here, mother is telling to the readers that what the children have found to look, unfolding feast into a gift. So here, they have found and they have fold in their hand and they open the folding hand this way. Okay, so they say that unfolding the feast like a gift of cork, pin, caption, pebble, thread. What they have found? They have found cork, pin also, some caption also, some pebble, some thread. The proof that loving eyes can sift. And for this, the loving eyes means the eyes of the children. They prove that these things, cork, pin, caption, pebble and thread, no? They are thinking that this is very important gift. So they prove that loving eyes can sift. The common silt for hidden gold. That means for them, these things are more valuable than the gold. Those glimmerings we lose with age. Here, glimmerings means small sign or symbols. That means now we have grown up and for us, small thing doesn't value anything, no? But here, those small things we lose with our age when we were child. We have lost everything that things that when we were child, we think that a small things is very precious and important to us. As prices tack, the story told, and what is lost fill us with rag. So here you see the price. There are priceless cork, pin, caption, pebble, thread, anything we got. What we used to do? We used to keep together. For example, now my daughter, she is very small and she don't know the value of the things. She think that everything is valuable, priceless. That means comparing to gold. So here, whatever she used to get, she will gather, she will keep with herself. Whether it is useless things, whether if I am throwing it away, she will keep and she will treasure it. Because now she is small and she don't know. And as we have grown up, now we think that we can imagine that those small things bring us a great joy in our life when we were a children. Then you see next, I hoard your findings, daughter and son. Here, hoard means store object valuable to one in a secret place. So here mother is saying that, my daughter, my son, the things which you have kept, which you have found and treasure, each little treasure you have named, and you have named each and small treasure. This my son and daughter has given a name of that treasure and pile on my decks one by one. Mother is saying that the small things which her daughter and son have got, have piled, that means kept together on the decks of his mother. Only like this the world is claimed. So in this way the world is going for them, for the small children's little things bring a great joy. It is not enough to find and hold, one needs to learn the art to keep. Here it is saying that it is not the thing that we find and we can keep hold, we can keep together, but one should know the art of keeping thing, like the small children does. They keep the things in one place like a secret treasure. What is found as if it was a gold. And for the small children, the small things they found, they think that it is like a gold. It's love or faith, it's a leap. So they keep with care, with love, with faith, and they treasure in one place, without which all is dropped and lost. If one is lost, then everything is dropped out and they think that everything is lost, and the child is to start crying, as we have seen, no, when it is small. On hard, inhospitable ground, that means unfriendly place, these small children things they are keeping in a place where difficult to stay or live, where price is known but not the cause, and nothing can never be found. The small things, price is known, but the price of the small thing is priceless, means cause doesn't matter, and nothing can ever be found. And we can see that things, what the small children found, cannot be found when we grow big. Now we have grown up, and for us think that everything is useless, only what we need, what we get, that is priceless for us. But for the small children, no, the useless things which we have thrown in the dustbin also they will pick up, and for them it is valuable like a gold. So here Tabiz Kher want to say us that when we were small, when we are in our childhood stage, we don't know what is more important to us and what is less important to us, but still we value all the thing same. I hope you have understood the poem, children. Please go through the poem and read it. If you have any doubt, you can get back to me. I hope so it is clear. Thank you.